Okay, it is late September, which means we're all going to be diving into 2017 annual planning if we haven't done so already. I just came back from Content Marketing World, and I took away from it three big things that as marketers we cannot afford to get wrong in 2017. So here they are. Number one, ignore best practices. Jay Akunzo said that good marketers follow best practices and great marketers craft their own. We have got to stop looking at best practices for what other people are doing. We will never stand out doing that. We've got to craft our own. And when we do that, we actually stop playing in the market and we start shaping it. And that's what we should be doing for 2017. But how do you do that? I mean, you just pull it out of thin air when you're not following a rule book. What do you do? And that brings me to number two. Number two, uncover insight. At the core of every brilliant marketing campaign, platform, movement is one crystal clear piece of insight, actual insight. The thing is, most of us stop at input. We base everything on data and stats, and that's just input. We need to go the extra mile to actually extract the true insight that helps us really move people. Doug Kessler gave a great example of a brilliant campaign called Dumb Ways to Die. And it was a super successful campaign around train safety, but it's because it was based on the insight that kids are more afraid of embarrassment than they are of death. That is a really powerful piece of insight in which they can base a ton of stuff. So stats give you one idea, give you one piece of content. A truly game-changing insight you can base your entire year on, thousands of pieces of content, a huge game-changing campaign. So I challenge you to really extract the insight into which you're going to base your 2017.
Dumb ways to die. So many dumb ways to die. Dumb ways to die. So many dumb ways to die.
And last but not least, number three, we have got to treat our content like a product. We are still thinking like marketers. We have this product to sell, and so we're gonna create great content around how awesome we are and the product is in an effort to sell that product. Instead, like Andrew Davis says, we need to be thinking like television executives. What amazing piece of content can we package and productize and brand in a way that drives demand for the other products that we sell? I mean, look at Pixar. Is Pixar a media company or is it a product company that's selling billions of dollars in stuffed animals and toys and lunchboxes and goldfish and just creating killer content that actually drives demand of the products that they sell?
I suffer from short-term memory loss.
So let's make sure that we're leading our teams to create the best stuff. Michael Brenner said, behind every piece of bad content is an executive who asked for it. Let's just make sure we're not that executive. So there are my top three takeaways as you're diving into annual planning. Best of luck over these next couple months. If I can help you in any way, whether it's actually working with your team on creating an annual plan or just getting them inspired, thinking creatively, finding the joy in work again, I work with some of the best marketing thought leaders in the country, and I have no doubt that we could help your team if it's something that you want. Definitely let me know. Otherwise, good luck and can't wait to see what you come up with.